This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we are cooking with Chef Shane from the Bradford. And today we're making a petite filet with a whole lot of other stuff. What are we making?
We're making a petite filet, Michaela, with a sweet onion port sauce and a creamy polenta. It's a great dish for Valentine's Day.
Okay.
It's nice and hearty, and I think it'll go well for yourself and your partner or your friend or whoever you have.
Perfect. Whoever you're hanging out with on Valentine's Day, it's probably a good meal, too. It's nice and warm and comforting after you've been doing hours of shoveling.
Absolutely. Couldn't be more right about that.
All right. So let's talk about the ingredients that we need for the recipe today.
All right. So we have an all-natural petite filet, usually about a 10-ounce cut. You can find that at Whole Foods. Most of your bigger markets do have a natural. I like the all-natural. It's got a much better flavor than some of your more processed meats.
Okay.
We've got, of course, a little bit of butter, some heavy cream, a little bit of blended olive oil, a Vidalia onion, salt and pepper, some fresh parsley, some yellow cornmeal, some ruby port wine, a little aged balsamic vinegar, and some dried black mission figs.
All right. Now, let's go back to this all-natural meat here. When you're looking at filet, what should you be looking for?
What you really want to look at is you see all the nice marbling in this filet. It doesn't have a whole lot of fat to it, but it does have a nice marble that runs through it. That's going to make it nice and tender as it cooks, and that marbling adds a lot of flavor to it.
Okay, great. And like we said, this will warm you up after these cold days, but how were you affected?
Actually, we were pretty lucky. We had a lot of snow and there was a lot of cleanup, but we didn't lose power. Things were good, so we just kind of hunkered down as a family and watched some movies and enjoyed the snow.
You braced the storm for sure. So this meal, about how many people is it going to feed today?
This is actually in individual portions. I've got enough here for two plates, but you know, we can share it. It'll be fun.
We'll share. Okay, great. Chef Shane and I are going to split this dish a little later on. Maybe we'll save some for Will if he's lucky, but we're going to get started in just a bit. Back to you.
Sounds good to me. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Shane is here from the Bradford. We're not huddling around this this stove for heat this morning.
Well, you know, we feel nice.
Although it feels good. What are we going to do now?
Right now, we're going to start our sauce.
Okay.
Our sweet onion port sauce.
Okay.
So what we're gonna do is we've got a warm saute pan here. It's getting hot. We're just gonna a little bit of oil, just enough to kind of coat the bottom of the pan.
Is this olive oil?
It's a 90-10 blend of olive oil. You want to use a straight olive oil because the smoke point is much too low, and you don't want to burn it
for
sure. All right. So we're gonna get that hot. We're gonna add. I've minced up some Vidalia onion here. You're going to use...
Yeah, Vidalia onions have such a great taste.
They do.
Too.
They're unbelievable.
They have
such
flavor.
A nice sweet flavor to them.
Yeah.
You're going to use about a tablespoon or so for this.
All right.
Not a huge onion flavor.
And that flavor will break down anyway while they're sautéing.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Once that sautés and gets hot, we're going to add a little bit of our port wine here.
Okay. Now this... This sauce that we are making, is this something, I know we're going to use the fillets today, but is this something that we could add to another recipe that we want to
do? Oh, absolutely. It's a very nice, sweet sauce. You could do it even on a grilled chicken.
Right.
I mean, I wouldn't suggest it for seafood, more for definitely for a meat or
a
poultry.
Chicken. Okay.
For sure. So we're going to let that kind of reduce just a little bit. We're going to add about the same amount, you know, about an ounce or so of aged balsamic vinegar.
Okay. The smell from this is great.
And basically, we're going to let that reduce down. While that's reducing, I like to add some of my black figs to it, which I've cut in half, so they really absorb the flavors
of
the wine and the balsamic vinegar.
A lot of people
may
not know what the flavor is from the fig. What is that going to add? What is that going to add? Is it going to add a sweetness to it?
It adds a little bit of a sweetness. It adds some texture as you bite into it because the seeds in the figs.
Right.
You know, very nice. It overall, it's a very sweet sauce.
Good.
And I figured perfect for Valentine's Day with that sweetness. So we're going to let that reduce down until it just coats the back of a spoon.
Right.
It should take about 3 or 4 minutes or so.
Okay, good. All right, it smells great in here. We are cooking away, huddled by the oven. Back to you. Back in the Rhode Show kitchen, we're here with Chef Shane from the Bradford and our petite filet.
Yeah.
Which is crackling away on this pan.
Yes, it is.
All right.
All right, so what I've done while we were gone is I've seasoned the filet with just very simply a little salt and fresh cracked pepper.
Okay.
I put it into a hot skillet. Again, you can do this on your grill outside or if you have a grill indoors, works just as well. I like to keep my seasonings pretty basic, salt, pepper, sometimes a little garlic.
So you don't take the flavor away, right?
Let the food speak for itself. What I'm going to do now is finish up my polenta. I've got a couple cups of water, a little bit of heavy cream, some salt and pepper, and a little bit of butter.
All right.
I'm going to whisk in my cornmeal.
Very important. Polenta comes together pretty quickly, is that right?
Absolutely. I mean, you don't want to let it simmer for a minute or two. But the very important thing is to whisk the cornmeal into it so you don't get lumps.
Okay, so gradually add that in there.
Absolutely. And we're starting to get our consistency now.
Right.
So we can see that coming up. We'll put this off to the side.
What consistency are we looking for, Chef?
You want it to be similar to, I guess I could compare it to maybe a cream of wheat.
Okay.
You want it to be fairly loose, but not so loose that it runs on the plate.
Yeah.
You don't want it to harden up on you.
You can see that coming together.
It's coming together now like instant potatoes.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Which I love.
Okay, Petite Filet.
Sorry, Chef. I love instant potatoes.
Listen, I'll give you a little guilty pleasure. There's nothing better than mom's meatloaf with a little instant mashed potato.
Glad you got my back.
So this is this is one of our regular menu items at the Bradford. We're also featuring it on our Valentine's Day prefix menu, which is a four-course prefix that we'll be featuring all week for Valentine's Day.
And what are those four courses? What do people get?
You'll have a choice of an appetizer, a salad, entree, and dessert. Some of those courses will be shared, and some of those will be individual options.
Nice. I like the sharing part, because my mistake is if I get an appetizer, I eat almost too much of it, and then the main course comes, and I say, can you just wrap it at this point? I filled up.
So
filled up on the apps.
Those are words you'll never hear from me.
Well, I eat the whole appetizer.
I eat the appetizer, and then, what's next?
All right.
How long is this meat going to cook? Because you don't want to overcook the filet, right?
Absolutely
not. It'll take the flavor away. It won't be so tender.
Absolutely. I'm going to say, in a pan like this, you're probably looking at about 4 to 5 minutes per side.
All right.
Okay.
Maximum, I like it on the rarer side, medium rare.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Naturally, if you like it a little more cooked, let it go a little
let
bit.
It go.
But again, I think, let's keep the meats under well done if
and
we
have
can.
Have you put just a little bit of oil in that pan?
I did, absolutely. Okay. Just a very small amount to coat the bottom of the pan.
Enough.
You don't want all that oil into it.
Good.
All right, we're just about ready to plate.
All right, great, Yuri. I will hand this over to you. And I can't help but, I know when you were making this sauce earlier, it smells
so really great.
Good. Chef, what went into this again? Definitely with some vinegar?
Some aged balsamic vinegar, some ruby port wine, a little bit of sweet Vidalia onion, and I finished it with just a little pat of butter.
Okay. Beautiful.
Because butter makes everything better.
Yes, it does.
So right
Speedo
in
is our motto
yes,
here in the Rhode Show Kitchen.
We have t-shirts and bumper stickers that say that.
We should get those.
So a little bit in the center of the plate.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you want to hold that for me?
Absolutely.
Great.
We are your sous chefs for the day.
Perfect. So you're going to take your filet, right
there
down on the center.
Wow.
Then we're going to spoon our
amazing
sauce.
You guys taking reservations for Valentine's Day?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Get them in soon.
We're going to fill up fast.
And quickly, what's the address of the Bradford?
142 Atwells Ave. It's a
great
neighborhood restaurant and bar. Warm, friendly, inviting. Come on and see us. The servers are great. Food is excellent.
That looks
shout out
fantastic
on something like this.
That
all right, if
fantastic
you want this recipe, make sure you head to our website. Beautiful.
WPRI.com.